Let's say you park your brand new car under the shade of a tree. When you return, you see it covered in bird droppings. You look up at the tree and see all the birds. How would you react? One man's expression of anger to an incident like that will haunt him for days. This is the story of a raven's revenge. Chapter 1. The Tragic Morning. It was a pleasant foggy morning in a city. The sun had just risen, chasing away the darkness of the night. The park was full of birds chirping away. It was a symphony worth your time. Among them was a raven. It was sitting on a tree at the edge of the park. Right below the tree was a brand new car. It was a shiny red masterpiece. It must have arrived from the showroom the night before. The owner of the car parked it there for shade, not knowing about the birds that nested on the tree. By midday, the whole car was covered in bird droppings. The man arrived with his family to go on a joyride. He turned furious to see the state of his new car. He looked up at the tree full of birds and found a raven sitting on the edge of a leafless branch. He was angry. "It is an expensive car, you stupid bird," he yelled. He picked up a stone from the street and throws it at the raven. The stone hit the raven's right wing. It struggled to fly and slowly fell to the ground. It was severely injured. All the other birds on the tree managed to fly away. The man saw the raven fallen helplessly on the ground. It was alive and crying for help. But he didn't care and walked away. The bird hopped its way into a shady patch of land and sat there to recover. The man and his family left. All the other birds returned to the tree. A few birds came down to comfort the injured raven. He was in a terrible shape. The man took the car for a wash, and just 15 minutes later, the car was shiny brand new again. He continued his journey to a nearby hill station. He eventually got over the bitter experience and enjoyed the day with his family. Back at the park, it was cold and started raining. The raven was still on the ground and soaked in water. He was unable to shake the water off his body because of his injury. He was in excruciating pain. The family returned from the journey late in the night. They parked the car further ahead from the tree and got down. They seemed happy, laughing aloud, recollecting the events of the day. Unlike the family, the raven was sad and angry. No one turned back to look at him, but the raven was watching them all, and now he wanted his revenge. Ah, 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 ah. Chapter 2 The Revenge. It was a Monday morning. The man was right on time. He seemed excited. He was going to show off his brand new car to his friends at the office. When he reached the car, he sees the lone raven sitting on it. The raven was feeling better. He managed to fly just enough to sit on the car and waited for the man to come. He fearlessly stared at the man. The man tried to shoo away the bird, but the raven had no plans to yield. The man was spooked by the raven's behavior. He rushed to sit in the car and drove away. The raven jumped off the car and signaled the other raven friends to follow. A flock of ravens slowly stalked the red car from behind. The man didn't notice anything on the way. He parked the car in an open parking lot and carried on with his daily routine. He and his friends gathered around at the coffee machine. They talked about his new car and wanted to go for a test drive later in the day. It was time for lunch. As they walked towards the car, they were in for a treat when they arrived. The man's red car was infested with ravens. It was covered in bird droppings again, and this time the birds built a nest on the car's windshield. He was embarrassed and scared at the same time. His friends made fun of him. There are hundreds of cars in the lot, and the ravens picked your brand new car to invade. What a mess, one of them said. The man explained to them what happened the day before. Some of them felt superstitious and left. Others were scared, but stayed with the man. They managed to chase all the ravens away, but one bird stood the ground. He was fearless and screamed back at them. I think it is him, the man said. The lone raven was outnumbered by the men and was chased away from the car. He was still in sight, watching them all. Let's get out of here, the man said. They got in and took the car for wash. I was here about the same time yesterday, the man said. They continued their discussion about what happened. They talked about what was right and wrong. In their conversation, the man carried no remorse. He still felt the display of anger was justified. The raven was watching them all as they speak. Sitting in a dark corner of the car wash, hidden from sight. After the wash, the car looked brand new again. The men were excited to see it in that shape and decided to test the limits of the machine. They drove to an empty highway and started their road rage. In no time, they were doing 160 kilometers per hour in almost a straight road. The raven picked up a heavier stone it could carry by its leg. It was flying against the direction of the car and dropped it on the windshield. The windshield shattered to pieces, and the men lost control of the car. They hit the barrier at a high speed, flipped the car twice, and landed on its roof. The men were in shock. No one had seen what hit them. They were hanging upside down, tightly held by their seat belts. They were alive, severely injured, but unable to move, just like the raven on the day before. The raven landed near the broken window of the car, looking at the man straight in the eye. The raven saw fear and anger in the man's eyes, but still no remorse. Feeling satisfied by what he managed to do, the raven flew away. Chapter 3. The Resolve. Three months after the incident, the man was still in the hospital. He had a broken leg and other minor injuries. His car was damaged beyond repair, and he was busy working on the insurance. It was not easy to claim the insurance, as they were caught overspeeding on the highway just a few minutes before the accident. He gets an unknown visitor, a yogi, wanting to talk about remorse. "Do I know you?" the man respectfully asks. "No, you don't, but I know about you. I know what you did and why exactly you are here," the yogi responds. The man was puzzled by the yogi's words. "I want you to meet my friend," the yogi says. As he points his hands towards the window, a raven flies in, leaving the man terrified. "Oh, do not worry about his presence. We are here only to talk," says the yogi.
"I thought this was over,"
the man responds in fear.
"It will not be over until my friend here gets his apology. He can feel it in your eyes. You still don't feel sorry for what you did. Why?"
the yogi asks.
"Look, I was angry. It was a brand new car, and it was messy the next day. What was I supposed to do?"
the man said. The yogi, nodding his head in disapproval,
"And whose mistake do you think it was?" "The tree is where the bird lives. It's their home. It was your mistake to park it under the tree. Just because it was a new car, you are not entitled to the way you reacted. However, the fact that it went this far was your response to the situation. If not help, he at least deserved an apology."
The bird walks on the man's broken leg, scaring the man even more.
He got his revenge. Now he wants to see remorse.
"Do you feel sorry for what you have done?" the yogi asks. The man responds in his trembling voice.
"Yes, yes, I do. I realize now it was my mistake. I shouldn't have reacted the way I did. I could have killed him, I understand. I'm really sorry."
The raven looks back at the yogi, feeling satisfied by the man's response, and flies away.
"Now, my friend, it is over. We may be better and more capable creatures among the animal kingdom, but we share the world with them too. We have taken away too much of what belongs to them. They are as much entitled to live in this world as we are. You have to surrender when it is their time to revolt. I wish you a speedy recovery," the yogi says as he departs. 2 months later, the man has bought a new car again. He parks the car under the same tree, but this time he covers it with a plastic wrap. He looks back at the raven, standing tall on the edge of the tree, fearlessly like he owns it.
Thank you for enjoying this edition of Stories for the Years. We would like to hear from you, so please leave your comments. If you like the story, please consider subscribing, and we'll bring you our next big story every month.